Hello, we'll see the whole purchasing P2P cycle for service procurement. First, we'll start with purchase requisition, then purchase order, then service entry sheet, and then the payment, which is MIRO, invoice verification. Now, the first thing for purchase requisition, we'll go to ME51N. Here we'll go through SSPR. You can refer the create purchase requisition video for this, how to create purchase requisition. We'll select account assignment as K, which is cost center. We'll select I, account assignment as D. Then we'll give a short description. Service, the required plant. It will ask you the mandatory fields or the required fields which you need to maintain to create this position. The service. Go in detail with how to create purchase requisition in our other video, in which I have in detail explained how to purchase requisition for services. I will create it, take it as 12. Why 12? I have considered that 1 month is one each, and I want the service for 12 months, so I have taken it as 12. This is the GM cost center, which I will show you again. The monthly charges, like 1 month charges 5,000 services. Here you can see the 60,000 for your 12 months. Here you have a constraint that the unit will be each. You usually don't mean you don't have the unit for month. Okay, then I will just check. Okay, still there are some errors. One of see, this is the beautiful feature of SAP. Here you can see enter purchase requisition. Okay, you need to maintain it, otherwise you will not be able to save. So I will select as one. Now the K attracts the cost center and GL field account. This cost center and GL. While we were maintaining the services, we got a tab to maintain these two. They are maintained over here. And the D services, D attracts service and leverage, these two fields. If you have not maintained D, you will not get these two fields. Okay, now you just check it and okay, it is done. You can save it. Just you can note down your service order number. Now we will create a purchase order with reference to our purchase requisition. For that, slash NME21N. This is the T code to create purchase order. Now we will select the appropriate document type, which is SSO. Then the system, you can go for document overview. Here you have to choose the purchase requisition. I will go to my purchase requisitions, which are created by me. Okay, these are they. I can go for purchase requisitions. Here there are many options. If you want to means always you will just refer the open purchase requisitions in the system. What is meant by open? Open means still it they are to be converted to PO. Purchase order is still not created. Released, the if you have a strategy for purchase requisition, so all released purchase requisition will be chosen over here. Just you need to and go for execute. Okay, and these are the many criterias. What which one criteria or multiple criteria you know about your requisition, you can maintain it over here. So I will just click on execute. Sorry, I will just go again and I will just a minute, there is some issue. Yeah, my purchase requisitions you can now choose your requisition and just say add on. Now here you have purchase requisition organization, you need to select it. It is 1000 and you need to vendor from which you want to procure the service. I will select it as this one. Okay, see the red message converted to yellow. Why? Because all the necessary fields are filled. Okay, you have maintained all the necessary fields. Now for how to create a purchase order, you go through my video where I have explained in detail how to create the purchase order. For now we will move on with this. Okay, here you have a condition tab. Here you can maintain, see, 60,000 is your whole price of 12 months. Now you can maintain if he has given any discount or any other condition. Usually no other condition is maintained. I will show you. Here is the bar for tabs. Here you will get a drop down for all tabs which are in this item series. Now see, you got this two tabs because of it came from the purchase requisition, but the service and limit tabs are attracted because you have maintained item category as D and the account assignment is attracted. This GL account and cost center are attracted because of account assignment category K. Fine, now I will just and it is done. We'll save the yeah. You have created a purchase order with this number. Now we will go to see. Now I have created a purchase order and I will send this purchase order to my vendor, and when he gives me a service for suppose for 2 months or 1 month, we'll take an example of 2 months. If he has given us a service for 2 months and we need to do the GRN, suppose GRN, or we need to record that we had got a service for 2 months, we'll go to ML81N. This is service entry to record that we have got a service for 2 months. Here I will go for other purchase order. Here you have the option to find it. I will just see purchase order for services. We had a 6 number purchase order. So I will just see, you got it over here. Now you need to say create new entry. Here you need to give the description or text. And now the service selection. Just okay, you will get a drop down a screen where you will get all the services which you have maintained in that particular purchase order. You need to select it and add up. Okay, you will get it over here. Now we have got a service for 2 months, so I will take a quantity of 2, and this is red. I will just accept it. Now it is yellow and I will just save it. Now it got green. Okay, now I will show you the purchase order again. Now you have recorded the 2 months charges in our system. I will just go to the purchase order. I will display you which is ME23N. This is the same purchase order for services which we have created. You will get a new tab over here which is purchase order history. You can see you have done this service entry sheet which is 194. In the background the system creates the material document with 101 movement type, which is like goods receipt. Okay, the accounting document you will be able to see over here. I will just click on it and this document info FI document and accounting document. Here you can see What GLs are? See, GRIR account is credited by 10,000 and the 660202, which we have maintained in the purchase order, is debited by 10,000. Now, this GRIR clearing account will be debited in our invoice verification and the payment will be done for the vendor. You also need to know the accounting entries when you are a customer. Now we will go to TCode /OMIRO, which is used for invoice verification. Now the vendor has provided us the services. We had recorded it in our system by ML81N, which is service entry sheet. Now we actually need to pay the vendor. For that, we will come to TCode MIRO. Here the invoice date. The vendor have given you an invoice. You need to maintain that date. Suppose we will take it as posting date. This is a mandatory field, which will be the invoice number. You can maintain the invoice number here. This is also a mandatory field. I will just keep something over there. Okay. Now the baseline. This is also, you can take today's date, 24/02/2018. Okay. Now you need to give the PO over here, which is, our PO number is 43. Okay, 10 is missing. Yeah. The only amount you will see over here, which you have recorded in the service entry sheet. We have recorded it for 2 months, which was 10,000. So you can see over here 10,000. Okay. Now you need to select the usually the tax code which is maintained in over here invoice tab. It comes to your Miro. Okay, we have not maintained it over here, so we need to select it over in Miro. Fine, we have selected 5%, it is GST 2.5 and 2.5. no, we will select, yes, 5%. Now you just need to select it over here also. 1A, sorry, yeah, 1A, and okay, 500 is the tax which you need to pay to your vendor. Now I will put the whole amount which was to pay, and you got a green message over here. You can see the accounting entries in simulate here. The TDS for that particular vendor is 100. The SGST and CGST is, which is calculated on 10,000, which is 250 and 250. And the GRIR account, which is 10,000, okay, which is debit, which gets debited over here, which was credited in the service entry sheet. And this whole amount will be paid to the vendor, okay. As it is a TDS, so you will cut the TDS and you will just pay 10,400 to your vendor. And I will just say post. Still contain some message. Okay, fine. We got message business place. Okay, fine. We need to maintain a business place over here. We'll just more time and see that if there is a message. Okay, the invoice verification is done. This is the particular number. This is the particular number for that invoice verification. You can just go and see this number in your purchase order here. Order history here. See, you can see that REL, which is your invoice verification, you got over here. Every document which is created with reference to this purchase order, you can see it over here. Now I have shown you the purchase requisition status tab. I will just show you it again. You just go to your purchase requisition status and see you have created a purchase order, you have created a good service entry sheet and invoice received. You will just get a data over here for your reference. Okay, thank you. If you have any doubts, you can comment below.